please subscribe, share videos, etc., etc. Today we're talking about watermelons. I'm going to enjoy this very nice watermelon right here. It's mostly a seedless watermelon. There are a few little tiny seeds in it. Here, take a look. Thank you. was staying here. Okay, that's actually the emblem of the shirt, something the manufacturer. Now, that's how we used to eat it. You just go down right like that. Going to use the fork and the knife a little bit. Hey, I'm speaking in my soft voice now, from whispering to soft voice. This will be a good chance for me to play this back and see which kind of voice I like. And I'd ask you all that before, which is the best voice, the whisper or the soft voice. Came back most of the soft voice. Anyway, you can tell me in the comments if you want to. And please feel free to comment. I love answer comments. If you're watching this in other parts of the world, and as some parts of the world don't have watermelons, they have some kind of melon, I guess. I don't know. If you're watching this far away, you have to tell me, do you have any kind of melons, watermelons, cantaloupes or whatever? And also just break it like this. I'll do something wrong here. Maybe make a real loud noise for the mic. It'll scare you. I don't want to do that. Eating watermelon might be one of my more boring videos. I don't know. Anyway, I have a lot of competition out there for the, you know, with other people who are eating too, as far as the most boring eating videos. But this is probably up in there, the top 10%. So I remember I've heard this part of the watermelon, the red part, referred to as the meat. And this part down here would be the rind. The rind. Rind. Lord, please don't let me drop my fork and scare everybody in the microphone. Really like to hear people chewing a lot. because I don't want to get watermelon juice on my shirt. Hey, here's a brilliant idea. Look how smart I am. Of seeds in here. You can see them very well. That didn't go as planned. The little seeds. I don't recall seeing watermelons without those big black seeds when I was young. You'd chew on it and then you'd just spit it out of your mouth like that. Keep my table clean. One piece that fell off the front here. Man overboard. Anyway, like a lot of farmers back then, and even now I guess, it was easier just to leave the watermelon in the field and just let it rot. It cost more to carry it to the market than we could get for the melons. My dad said it was always like you take the crop to the market and then it's what'll you give me? What do you give me? The farmers had no representation. But one of my mom's cousins was the president in our county of the National Farmers Organization, the NFO. And these are farmers who banded together and tried to be like a union, basically. Sort of co-op together and get a higher price for their crops. But this was in the late 60s, early 70s. And my dad was the vice president for that area. Basically, it pretty much failed. But they also had they did things to attract people's attentions to the plight of the farmer. Like in some up north, they would pour the milk out. Just pour the milk out on the ground. Because it was not even worth it to carry the milk to the market. People would say, oh, that's terrible, those awful farmers. Well, why do you think there are fewer farmers today? Why do you suppose so many left the business? Okay, I'm eating a watermelon here. Anyway, it was easier just to leave the watermelons in the field and just let them rot. And people would come along from, you know, mostly from in the town sometimes, or even living in the country, and they would just steal the watermelons out of the field. Now, you can't put guards around the field, so they would steal our watermelons. But we gathered these things. My dad took a big old yellow school bus, the yellow school bus that you see everywhere, and he cut the top off. I have a picture of it. I try to go through all my pictures if I keep making these videos. But it's just a school bus with the top cut off. So you couldn't carry stuff if it was going to rain. And we carried crops and corn and tobacco and everything in that old school bus. It was fun going along the road and being up there on the top, you know, looking out everywhere. Real dangerous. I think there are laws against that now, but back then there wasn't. So these melons probably weighed five pounds or so, and I was about the same weight back then as I am now. So I had to pick them up off the ground and hand them to the person in the truck. You know, some stack them in the truck, or the bus rather in our case. The lucky ones was if you were standing up in the bus, and I tried to get that job, then the other person on the ground had to lift it up to you. So I think I mentioned a couple years we just let the watermelons just rot. Maybe one year we took them to market. Yeah, I know we did at least once. And one year we let them rot in the field. And another year, my dad took a load of the watermelons to a children's home, kind of like an orphanage, because some farmers were donating like that, I guess. My dad found out about it, and I think he took them like, I don't remember how far it was, 100 miles, 200 miles, to a home, a children's home in the upper part of the state. Sorry, I went into a little bit of detail, a little emotion about the farmers and, you know, how hard it was to be a farmer. I want this channel to be entirely non-political. I don't want to talk about any weighty, terrible issues. But that's part of my story. It's much easier just to sit here and eat food, like a lot of ASMR artists do. I don't know anybody that tells stories like this, but they're not all happy stories. I don't know if I should be telling them or not. Also, there are privacy issues. Be careful about talking about people who, whether they're living or dead, and my own privacy too. I don't have to give away so much. Keep it light. Keep it happy. Just eat. Just eat it. Eat it. Just eat it. It doesn't matter what you had for lunch. Just eat it. As far as we're gonna go today, I just can't eat any more of this. It's so delicious, though. So, hope you enjoyed the video and the story. And I'll catch you next time. Peace out.